Welcome to the Paper Crafters Library. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create this Halloween jack-o'-lantern card. So I'm going to start by showing you how to create this little three-dimensional jack-o'-lantern. I'm using Stampin' Up's Jack of All Trades stamp set, and I've got the largest of the pumpkins. So I'm going to start with, here I have a scrap of Whisper White cardstock. I'm going to ink up my pumpkin in Pumpkin Pie Classic ink, and I'm going to stamp it twice onto my scrap of Whisper White cardstock. Like so. I'm then going to take the hat and I'm going to ink that up in black ink. Now I'm using Jet Black Archival ink. You can also use the Jet Black Stays-On ink as well. So I'm inking that up and I'm stamping that onto my scrap. And then finally I'm going to take my jack-o'-lantern face and I'm going to ink that up in my black ink and stamp that. Now, one of the jack-o'-lanterns and the hat and the face, I'm going to be cutting out the entire image. But for the other one, I'm going to be cutting out segments. So I'm going to cut out this segment here. So like that, and then I'm going to be cutting out this middle segment. So there you can see what that looks like, and I'm going to be using those two pieces to build the dimension on the pumpkin. So I'm just going to go ahead, I'm going to cut these pieces out, and I'll be right back. So I've got all the pieces of my jack-o'-lantern cut out, and it's now time to start assembling it. Now, because I'm not planning on putting a stem on this, it's going to be covered by the hat, I'm actually going to flip this upside down. So it almost looks like the bottom curve of the pumpkin, which means that when I put on these pieces, they, of course, are also going to get flipped upside down. Like so. Now to give the pumpkin some dimension, I'm going to be attaching these pieces using Stampin' Dimensionals. So I'm going to attach first one piece, and then I'm going to snip ends and stick that on this piece, and that just gives me a little bit narrower piece. So now I'm going to peel the backing off of those pieces. And I'm going to attach this piece like so. And then for my hat, I'm going to stick that, I think, using a dimensional as well. I'll probably put a couple dimensionals here. I'm just going to angle that to the side like so. Now for the face, you can either stick it on flat and You can see that's what I did here. The face is on flat, or you can use dimensionals to give it some extra pop. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this one with dimensionals. So I'm just going to put dimensionals here on the back of the smile and the eyes and the nose, and then we'll be back to stick it onto the jack-o'-lantern. So I've placed dimensionals on the back of all my pieces. So now I'm just going to remove the backing and I'm going to stick them down. And it's kind of helpful to have tweezers to help you both pick off the backing of the dimensional, since the piece is so small, as well as place it on your pumpkin. Actually, I think I'm going to put that just a little bit lower down. Then I'll do the mouth and then the nose last. So I'm just, same way you saw me apply the eyes, I'm just removing the backing from the dimensionals and I'm going to attach my face pieces. So there you can see what my pumpkin looks like. The next thing I'm going to do is to take some yellow rhinestones and I'm going to take the medium size and I'm going to put them right in the center of his eyes. And I chose yellow because generally you have a candle inside jack-o'-lanterns which tends to flicker or look yellow. Now, these are just rhinestones I picked up at the dollar store. If you're working with Stampin' Up's clear rhinestones, you can simply take a yellow Sharpie marker or Copic marker and color them to give you that yellow color. So there you can see what our little jack-o'-lantern now looks like.